Welcome to Understanding Your Dreams. As usual, we continue looking at the Word of God and understanding the context of things that He may speak to us. My name is Peter. I'll be reading from Job chapter 33 and verse 14. He says that, "For God does reveal His will. He speaks not only once, but more than once, even though men do not regard it. One may hear God's voice in a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls upon men while slumbering on their bed. Then He opens the ears of men and seals their instruction, terrifying them with warnings, that He may withdraw man from his purpose and cut off pride from him." So, in many times, God speaks to us in dreams. He speaks to us in visions. In this series, we are continuing to look at common dreams that people ask. We've been looking at discernment, and now we want to look at the different characters that we see in dreams, and that and how it may help us as we move on in the Word of God. So now we are looking at snakes. A number of people say that they are dreaming snakes are running after them, or a snake has bitten them in their dreams. So we want to start by looking at the Word of God. Remember, the Word of God is the safest place to be in. So we are looking at snakes or serpents. So the first place that we find a snake in the Word of God is in the book of Genesis chapter 3. And in Genesis chapter 3, there we have the story of Adam and Eve. God had created man and put them in the garden, and He commanded them not to eat of the tree that was in the middle of the garden. But then we see that the serpent, that was more subtle than any of the beasts that the Lord had made, came and spoke to the woman and said, "Did God really say, you shall not eat of these things?" So eventually, after a conversation, the woman got the fruit, ate some of it, and also gave a part of it to the husband who was with her. So now, if a person is having dreams that they are snake, firstly what we see is that the enemy came and challenged the Word of God by deception. So a snake in your dream can represent deception or lies. So there are people who can come to you with deception, but it's not always somebody coming in the context of lies. Sometimes people deceive themselves. So if you believe a lie, again, you can see a snake in your dream because you are seeing deception at work. So the snake is a symbol of the devil or the dragon. We also see that in Revelation chapter 12, talks about the dragon, that old serpent. So we know that the snake or the serpent is a symbol of the dragon or Satan himself. So sometimes a snake in your dream just represents demons or the power of the enemy that is at work. And remember, when the power of the enemy comes, John 10:10 says the enemy comes in order but to steal, to kill, and to destroy, but I have come that you may have life and life to the full. So it represents the devil. A snake can also represent lies. Sometimes you may be talking to people, you're planning your business, planning this big contract that you're going to do like this. And then after that discussion, you just have a dream, there are serpents all around. And maybe God is telling you that the people you're dealing with are just serpents, they are telling you lies. Sometimes a person can be dating and they're believing somebody's lies, and the Lord may just show you a snake coiling around you just to tell you that whatever you are believing is a lie being told to you. And then again, we see that the enemy distorted the truth. So a snake is a symbol of distortion, distortion of the Word of God. So there are people that you may be listening to, and when you finish listening to them, all you are seeing are snakes all around your life. Maybe you need to pay attention. Who was I listening to? What were they saying? Was it in line with the Word of God? If it wasn't in line with the Word of God, it may have been a lot of distortion that sounded good, but not based on the Word of God. For example, when Jesus was tempted after 40 days of prayer and fasting, the enemy came and said, "If you are the Son of God, turn these stones into bread. If you are the Son of God, can you jump from here? His angels will take charge over you." Of course, he was quoting Psalm 91, but he had twisted it for his own end. So when the enemy speaks to you, he will have come with deception. So sometimes it's things going on in your normal life. It's not always witchcraft. It can be in the workplace. It can be at the church. You are listening to somebody. They sound clever, but they are just speaking with the voice of the enemy. So again, it can be the dragon. If you remember, in the book of Exodus chapter 4 and verse 3, Moses is called by the Lord to go and save the children of Israel. And the Lord asks Moses, what do you have in your hand? And he says, I have a staff, or a rod, a shepherd's rod. Remember, a rod is a symbol of authority, it's a symbol of the shepherd. So that staff was a symbol that represented who Moses was and what Moses was doing. The Lord says to Moses, throw it down. When he throws the rod down, it becomes a snake. He runs away from it and he picks it up by the tail. It becomes the rod of God. So perhaps it could be that maybe it was a symbol of the character, that he had not maybe lined up with him. Maybe he was living a lie. Remember, he ran away from Egypt because he had murdered a man. So he could have been living a lie, and maybe God demonstrated it in that way. Of course, we know in later on his snake became a rod and they tapped the rods of Pharaoh. Also, the snake was a symbol of Pharaoh. Pharaoh was the king of Egypt. And so because he was symbolized by the snake, sometimes a snake can represent a power, a authority. You can look at the type of snake you're seeing in a dream. Is it a cobra? Because the king of snakes, is it an anaconda? Is it a python? There are those that constrict. There are those that want to take the breath out of you. If you're seeing that snake, maybe there's something taking the breath out of your life. So there are different types of snake. But all in all, we can say they are symbols. Some authorities are like snakes. They are very oppressive. So those leaders who cause oppression and suffering on the people, you can look at them under this symbol. God can give you a symbol of the snake that is tormenting people. In Numbers chapter 21 and verse 6, this is a story when the children of Israel have sinned. And the Lord said, send fiery serpents among the people to go and bite them. And then the Lord commands Moses, make a serpent, a fiery serpent, and whoever looks at that rod, of that image of the serpent, they shall be healed. So again, it's appealing to their character. The people were deceptive. Their people were dishonest. And so God sent them something that was like their nature, a snake, to go and bite them. And the ones who would repent and have faith would look at it and be healed. So again, snake can represent your actual character, or maybe a judgment that is there. In Psalm 58 and verse 4, it says the words of the wicked are like poison. So the words of the wicked are like poison. So sometimes God can show you a snake, and maybe you are hearing somebody speaking, and maybe what they are saying is poisonous, it is destructive. Paul says that bad company corrupts good character. So if you are hanging around with people that have bad company, bad ways, their words will be like poison. They will distort your life. They will destroy your destiny. They will destroy your outlook, because when you believe them, it is like death has come into you. So again, these wicked people who speak wicked ways, sometimes it's not non-believers. Sometimes it's people you know, people you congregate with. But when you look at their ways, they are slanderers, they are destroyers. They only speak evil about other people. Their ways are poison. When they finish speaking up about another person, you wonder whether they are believers or not. So again, there can be snakes in the church, there can be snakes in the nation, there can be snakes in the workplace. So beware of who you are hanging around with. Maybe God is showing you a dream surrounded by snakes. Maybe those are your friends. In Psalm 140, it says the tongue of these people who are wicked is like the tongue of a serpent. When it bites, it causes great pain. Again, there are people whose words pierce like a sword. When they speak, you wish you had not heard. There are people who can be leaders. When they speak, you really wish you had not heard what they are saying. There are people who can be your friends. When they speak, you really regret that they were saying. They can be your relatives. They can be your cousins. They can be your brothers. It can be anybody. But there are people whose tongues are evil. If you are hanging around them, your life can be destroyed. So when you have a dream and there are snakes, you have to look at these verses. Don't always rush to witchcraft. I know, because the snake is a symbol of the enemy, a symbol of powers of darkness. Most of the time we want to be in a hurry to say, this is a witch, A demon has come, somebody has bewitched me. Sometimes God is not talking about the witch. Even the witch you may suspect, he may not be talking about that, but he may be talking about your friend, the people who are close to you. Maybe you are playing around with snakes. In Proverbs chapter 30, verse 19, this is an interesting verse. The writer of that proverb says, the way of a young man with a young maiden is like a snake on a slippery surface. So this young man is moving around with a young lady, and Solomon says, I don't understand. It's like a snake. It's slippery. It's clever. So God may show you a snake on the rock. Maybe you are dating a young woman or a young man, or somebody is speaking nice things to you, and you really think this is good, and maybe he shows you a snake on the rock. There is a scripture for that. Maybe that's what God is saying. In Isaiah 27, verse 1, the Bible talks about Leviathan, the piercing serpent. So now we can relate directly the snake to the devil. Leviathan is a serpent, a piercing serpent. So a person who hangs around with the devil will be pierced or destroyed. So what have we said? We've said that snakes are a symbol of deception. Snakes are a symbol of witchcraft. A symbol of demons, powers of darkness. We've said that snakes are a symbol of lies. It can be a whole lot of things that God is bringing your attention to. So you need to look at the context. Where was the snake? The snake was at church. Where was the snake? It was in the workplace. Where was the snake? It was in my home, in a family meeting. If it's in a family meeting, then you know the snake is among the family members. If it's in your board meeting, at work, you know the snake is in the board. If the snake is in your church, in your board meeting, you know that the snake is just around here, hanging around the church. And if your snake is in your house, you know that the snake is in your family. So look at the context. So look at context in other dreams. But one great thing is that God told Eve that your seed shall crush the head of the serpent. So if you see a serpent in your dream, God has given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Luke chapter 4, verse 17 to 19. I've given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions, and nothing by any means shall harm you. So until the next time, this is Peter Kansembe. Once again, shalom. You can like my page on Facebook, Peter Kansembe Understanding Dream, for more lessons, or you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, Peter Kansembe Understanding Dreams, and we'll be more than glad to assist you. Until the next time, shalom.